Hello students, now we will discuss some questions related to whole numbers. Okay, so the first question is, write the predecessor and successor of these numbers. Okay, we have to find out predecessor and successor. So what we will do? Solutions. First, we have to find out successor and predecessor of. The first number is 19. So, I already told you in my last video that predecessor means decreasing 1 or subtracting 1 from a number, and successor means adding 1 to a number. So, predecessor of 19 is, we have to subtract 1, it is 18. Okay? And successor of 19 is, we have to add 1 in it. So 19 plus 1 is 20. Is it clear? This is how we find out successor and predecessor. The second one is 1997. We have to find out predecessor and successor. So predecessor will be equal to 1997 minus 1. So what will be the answer? 1996. And what about successor? We have to add 1 to this number, will get 1998. This is the successor. Now the third is 1200. 1200. So the predecessor of 1200 will be equal to minus 1. Say minus 1 karenge. Then we will get 99. Sorry, it's 12,000. 9, 9, 9, 1 and 1. So, the predecessor of 12,000 is 11999. And successor will be equal to 12,000 plus 1. So, 12,000. It's just simple. We are adding 1 and subtracting 1. Next is 49. So, what will be the predecessor? 49 minus 1 is 48. And successor is 49 plus 1 equal to 50. Is it clear? Now the last one is 3, 4, 5. Predecessor is subtract 1. So we'll get 9, 9, 9, 9, 9. Okay? And successor is plus 1. This is the successor. Is it clear? Now, question number second. What is question number second? It is true or false. The first one is, are all natural numbers also whole numbers? Are all natural numbers whole numbers? We already know that natural numbers start from 1, 2, 3 like this. And whole number starts from 0. So, are all natural numbers whole numbers? Yes, because natural numbers are starting from 1 and whole number are starting from 0. So, all natural numbers are included in whole numbers. So, the first one is true. Yes, all natural numbers are whole numbers. Now, the second one. Second is, are all whole numbers natural numbers? As we know, whole number starts from 0 and natural numbers start from 1. So, it is false. All whole numbers are not natural numbers. The second one is false. Okay. And the third one. What is third one? Which is the greatest whole numbers? Which is the greatest whole number? We cannot say what is the greatest whole number. Why? Because it is up to infinity. We cannot count. But we can say that what is the smallest whole number? Smallest whole number is 0. And what is the smallest natural number? It is 1. So, the greatest whole number is, we can't say, or it's infinity. Is it clear? Now, question number third. Question number third is, add 1 plus 6 on a number line. We have to add 1 and 6 on a number line. So, how we will do this? 1 plus 6 on a number line. So, what we will do? Firstly, we will draw a number line using a scale. Then we will start from 0 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You have to take equal intervals. Okay. Now we have taken up to 7. So how we will add this? We have the first number is 1. So we will start from 1 and we will jump 6 position. We will jump 6 times towards right hand side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have jumped 6 times. So where we have reached up to 7. So 1 plus 6 is equal to 7. Is it clear? Now, fourth question is, the fourth question is subtract 6 minus 2 on a number line. Okay, so how we will subtract 6 and 2 on a number line? Again, we will draw a number line 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, we'll start with the greatest number 6. We have to subtract 2 from 6. So what we will do, we will start from 6 and we move or we jump 2 positions towards left hand side. This and this. So where we have reached? 4. So 6 minus 2 is equal to 4. Just remember, on adding we will move towards right hand side, on subtracting we will move towards left hand side. Okay. Now fifth question. In fifth question, we have to multiply 3 into 3 on a number line. So how we will multiply this? Just see. 3 into 3. Again, for this I will draw a number line. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. We have to multiply 3 into 3. So in multiplication, what we do, we start from 0 and we'll take, the first number is 3. So we'll take the interval of 3 and we move up to 3 times like this. Interval of 3. Why 3? Because the first number is 3. And how many times we jump? The second number. Second number is 3. So we'll jump 3 times by taking 3 intervals of 1 unit each. This one and last is this one. So we have jumped 3 times by taking 3 units interval. Okay, so where we have reached? 9. So 3 multiplied by 3 is 9. Now you understood how to add, subtract and multiply on a number line. So students, that's all for today. Now I am giving you some questions related to today's topic. Do solve it and I will share the answer sheet in my next video. Okay. Thank you. Have a good learning.